These are not dangerous revolutionaries in a beleaguered city under martial law. These are teenagers on the Sunset Strip in Los Angeles, California, on a peaceful night. Irresponsible, wild, beat, protest youths, with nowhere to go, nothing to do, no goal in life. Just searching for one thing they've demanded throughout the ages, the right of self-expression and recognition. What you see here is happening all over the world. In every country, the question is the same. What to do about the youth problem?
Officer, it's getting worse every night. I've never seen such riffraff. Now, the authorities ought to do something about it. I'm sick and tired of it.
I'm going down to the strip tonight. I'm not on a stay-home trip tonight. Long hair seems to be the main attraction, but the heat is causing all the action. Bright lights everywhere, pretty girls with long blonde hair, but somehow the people, they don't care. It just doesn't seem fair, too buggy cause you got long hair. Even the parents are beginning to scare, because of the siren on our street. It used to be neat, but now it's just a place where black and white cars to race. It's causing a riot. It's causing a riot. But somehow the people, they don't care. Just doesn't seem fair to buggy cause you got long hair. Even the parents are beginning to scare, because of the sirens on our streets. It used to be neat, but now it's just a place where black and white cars to race. It's causing a riot.
Our story starts on the campus of an ordinary high school. It could be in your town or mine.
Hey, come on! Come on!
With ordinary kids, like yours or mine.
Dig these new wheels!
Yeah, how do you like it?
It's bus, Grady. I love it, love it. What's it run on, gas or kerosene?
Lighter fluid.
You met Lizanne.
Oh, hi, Lizanne. How you doing? Hey, who's the wild one?
Oh, well, this is Andy. She's new here. She just got here last month.
Andy who?
Dahlia.
Hey, well, jump in. I'll give you all a ride home. Come on.
Great, great.
Come on. You want a lift, Andy?
No, thank you. I'll take the bus.
Oh. Hey, I just got a great idea. Let's all go to Pandora's Box tonight.
Crazy.
Oh, I dig that.
You want to come, too?
Oh, I think I should stay home. Oh, come on. You can make it, Andy. It's a ball. Okay. Could you pick me up at Lizanne's house?
Sure, groovy, right after chow. Okay, we'll see you later.
Yes, today's youngsters are no different than we were. When school's out, they plan their nights out. Their plans usually include a trip to the Sunset Strip, where teenagers and young adults, wearing outlandish clothes and hairdos, from within a radius of 100 miles, congregate every Friday and Saturday night. walking around aimlessly, blocking the traffic and the sidewalks, much to the disapproval of the older generation.
Friend comes in handy, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Hey!
Look, I don't make the rules, Grady. If you want a little blast in your diet drink, I can understand that.
What are you, Gestapo or something?
The manager, honey. And I have to live with the police department. If one of them took a sip of your drink instead of me, that's all, brother. They padlocked me so fast. Now, minors drinking in my place.
Unit 37, Unit 37, code 459, possible 211, 1865 North Fairlane. Repeat, 1865 North Fairlane. Unit 37, acknowledge.
Unit 37, roger, roger. Proceeding to 1865 North Fairlane. Over and out. So we begin another jolly, thrill-packed evening in Kittyland.
You said it.
Let's see that, Sonny. Grass.
So what's wrong with smoking?
Yeah.
It just so happens that smoking that stuff's against the law.
So is breaking and entering. And trespassing.
So what harm are we doing? Who are we bothering?
The landlady, for one. She called in.
Look, the only reason grass is illegal is that the public doesn't understand. It's an anachronism.
Aren't we better off sitting here than getting hung up drunk and cutting out on wheels, killing each other?
It's still against the law, miss.
It's a bad law. A little public education, and as soon as the public understands,
they'll
change the law.
Sure, sure. Why don't you save this for your hearing? Maybe you can do some good with the judge.
Yeah.
I honestly can't believe you two are my daughters. This is what you call a Van Nuys slumber party? Look at you two. Compared to you, Dracula looks like a fairy princess. Did you get those ridiculous clothes? You certainly weren't wearing them when you left home yesterday. What you do is go to play them dirty up. Oh, wait, wait. On second thought, maybe it would be a good idea to make her keep you here in jail. Teach you a good lesson. Officer?
Yes?
Would you do me a favor?
Of course.
Would you lock up these two tramps and throw the key away?
Sorry, lady. We already got our hands full as it is.
Come on, you two. I'll let your father take care of this when we get home.
And now to another point. You know that the merchants, businessmen, and real estate owners are forming an association to save Sunset Strip. To save the Sunset Strip from ruination by the invasion of long hairs. They're petitioning not only all the top officials, but anybody to do anything.
I've heard that, yes.
Doesn't that indicate to you, sir, that the situation is crucial?
Well, I wouldn't say it was crucial. Serious, maybe. I agree we have a problem, but I think we're well able to keep it under control.
What about vice? Kids, underage kids. Drinking, smoking marijuana, using drugs, acids. Would you say you have that under control?
Mr. Stokes, I'm not pretending these kids are little angels. There are law infractions, but when my men and the sheriff's men find such infractions, they crack down. You'll find quite a few violators out there in reception. But these are kids, Mr. Stokes, our sons and our daughters. Maybe they create a nuisance ganging up in one small area, but do you want me to throw them all in jail for that?
But are you advocating that we keep hands off? Let them riot, rock buses, destroy property, frighten innocent passersby?
No, I don't propose to let them or anyone violate the law and get away with it. But getting together in groups is not unlawful assembly as long as they keep quiet and peaceful. When they start disturbing the peace or becoming a nuisance or the things that you mention, then they constitute unlawful assembly. Then they're in violation, and that's when my men will move in. That I can assure you, Mr. Stokes. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a lot of work to do.
Thank you. That concludes our interview, ladies and gentlemen, with Walter Lorimer of the Hollywood Division. Good evening. Thanks, Walt. The
interview will be on the air.
You're welcome to it.
Watch the camera on the door. Nice. Coffee, Walt?
Yeah, Frank, thanks. I need it. You know, try to use a little restraint and common sense. They tell you to crack down. Then you move in, lean a little, they scream, police brutality.
That's about it. Put on a badge, and there's just one thing sure. You can't win.
Huh? You want bread, man? We'll demonstrate for all of us.
Yeah. Oh, well, then why don't you demonstrate out on the street? If you want to demonstrate in here, cough up the cover.
What are you, a fake for the
man? He sure is. Hi, I'm with you.
Well, I'm not. We paid $5 to get in here and drove all the way from Garkin.
Big deal. Our cops were...
You and your course. Get out of here.
I'm with you, Perry.
Come on, come on, come on.
hear that?
Well, I know the way out of here. Will you just follow me and hang tight? Put your foot.
Out kind of late, aren't you, sport? Come on out of the car.
Around here, young lady.
Hey, you guys aren't going to give us the stuff about curfew again, are you?
That depends. Let's see your ID, please. You too. Well, I'm afraid we are.
Oh, look, if you think we had anything to do with that jazz in there, you're wrong.
We didn't say anything about that jazz in there. Come on over here and put your hands on the hood. Come on.
And you, young lady, your ID.
I don't drive.
What's your name?
Elizabeth Ann Babry. They call me Liz Ann.
And your friend?
I don't drive either.
What's your name?
Andrea. Andrea Dahlia. My friends call me Andy.
What makes you think they're your friends?
How old are you kids?
17.
17.
Which one's Philip Collar? And he must be Grady Toss. Well, 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 what's this?
My old man's gonna blow his mind.
Here are the names, Harry.
Thank you, Dick.
Grady Toss.
Here.
Philip Collar.
Me.
Elizabeth Ann Barbary.
Yes.
And Andrea Dahlier.
Now, just give me the phone numbers of your homes, and your parents will be called, and they can come and collect you.
All right. Mine is Crestview 50703.
Crestview 57565.
876-8819. Don't call now. My old man's never home at night.
Okay, you three kids go over there.
You, Miss Dahlier.
Yes, sir.
We need your phone number.
What?
Your parents' phone number?
I'd have to see a phone book.
All right, let's get a phone book and let her call.
Yes, sir.
Book these three for inciting a riot. That includes you. Yes. The rest of you, just wait here for your parents.
Mom, we were just dancing this time. Sorry to have bothered you, Mrs. Tweedy.
Oh, it's no bother at all, Andy. It's so good seeing you after all this time. How long has it been?
It's been 4 years, 3 months, and 2 days.
I know. I'll admit it was a surprise, that phone call from you after all that time.
I didn't know who else to call.
Now, what direction? Where are you living now?
Oh, I wouldn't ask you to take me home.
Oh, it's no trouble.
No, please. Just take me to the nearest bus stop. That'll be fine.
It's no trouble, Andy.
I've been enough trouble as it is. To everyone.
You're not any trouble, Andy.
You're tough guys. With your badges and guns. Picking on a lot of little kids out having a little fun. Why don't you go after some real criminals? The gangsters and mobs that are strangling this country. Maybe a few murderers. Nah, you're too chicken for that. Stir up a little too much grease around here.
Pop, will you cool it?
Don't you tell me to cool it. Dragging me 40 miles from my garage in the middle of the night to come out and get you out of the clink? Peace officers. Why, you jokers couldn't keep peace at an old lady's church social.
All right, mister. Do us a favor and take your boy home and yourself too. Come on, Walt, let's go home. All the dear parents showed.
Some.
Maybe we ought to ask for a bonus on all this new business.
Hey, you got any plans?
What do you mean? Just because I'm a bachelor doesn't mean...
I mean, Helen just phoned. Asked me to bring you home for a snack. No, no, strike that. Let the record show she ordered me to bring you.
Helen. You got a rare one there, Frank. Pick of the litter,
will you come quietly, or shall I bring out the cuffs?
When do you advise me of my rights?
What rights? When a woman like Helen cracks the whip, none of us has any.
The night. Doing God knows what. Suppose I'd have needed you for something. Did you ever think about that? Get in here. You want me to catch my death standing here? Get in here.
Well, the parents, they're the ones we should be busting.
You must remember, Frank, that a lot of these children come from broken homes. Like Walt's daughter, Andy.
Helen, not now, please.
It's all right, Frank. It's all right. It's been a long time now, getting kind of used to it.
It's been 4 years since you've seen Marge or Andy.
Helen, please.
The only contact I have with them now is when I send the support checks to the court and they forward them somewhere.
You mean you don't even know where they're living?
No. What difference would it make? They don't want to see me anyway.
I saw Andy.
Oh, when?
Tonight.
Tonight where?
At the station house. Your station house.
She came to see me and I wasn't there?
No, Walt.
Why didn't she wait?
Walt, you don't understand. She didn't come to see you.
Helen, please.
Frank, I know what I'm doing. When we first came from England and you joined the force, while everybody else was making fun of you, it was Walt who helped us. Well, I think he needs a friend now, and we're here to...
Wait a minute. What are you two trying to talk about?
Well, Walt, Helen asked me to bring you home tonight because... Well, because she wanted to tell you about Andy and...
What about Andy? Something happened to her? Was she in an accident? Well, why don't you tell me something?
Andy was picked up near Pandora's box.
Just a curfew violation.
Well, she should have seen me anyway.
The last one she'd ask for. She called me.
Funny. Before her mother and I split up, Andy and I were so close. But why did she call you instead of her mother?
I don't know, Walt. I only know your little girl needs help. She needs someone. And she either can't or won't turn to her mother.
She tell you where she lives?
No. She wouldn't let me take her home, just to the bus stop, no further.
Well, it's easy to find out. Being in the police department has some advantages.
Have you ever tried before?
You know I haven't. I didn't want to stick my nose in where it wasn't wanted. Helen, I'm glad you stuck your nose in.
Grady, you're not grounded.
No! My old man was so bugged at the cops, he forgot to pull my wheels.
Then we make the strip scene again. It's what's happening.
Oh, crazy.
Groovy, huh, doll? I don't think I can make it. I mean, after what happened last time.
You mean being picked up by the cops? Curfew violation, that's nothing.
Oh, it's like the measles. Once you had them, they never bother you again.
I know. It's not that. It's just don't count on me. I'll see you later. It's that bad, huh? At home, I mean. Well, you know how it is. Try to make it, though, huh? If you can, give me a call, okay? Okay.
Well, that's too bad. A cute little fox like that, all crazy, mixed up. What's her bag, anyway?
Not her, honey. It's the old lady. She's a juicer.
Oh, what a drag. It's worse than weeds.
Grown-ups, you can't leave him out of your sight for a minute.
What about her old man? Is he on the juice, too?
Who knows? He's the invisible man.
You mean nobody's ever seen him before?
For that, you'll get a high IQ.
High IQ, too? Let's split.
What do you propose, Walt? What's your solution? Everybody'd like to know. The whole city. The whole world, for that matter.
I don't have a solution.
That's hard to take, Lorimer. You're the assigned watch officer, and theoretically, you're responsible for law enforcement on the Strip.
Theoretically?
Yes. And we're more or less forced to entrust our well-being, our business future, and the keeping of the peace to you.
We aren't allowed to take the law into our own hands.
You're darn right you aren't.
Might be interesting, don't you think? Can you just picture a group of vigilantes on the Strip, armed with barber shears? And after we've grabbed a few of these Goldilocks boys and fixed them up with crew cuts, I'll bet you they'd all take to the hills.
What about a few baths? Maybe we'll get some shoes for their feet.
No, no. Now, let's not be sadistic.
And that would solve the problem, wouldn't it? Chase the kids off the Strip, and you could make another mint in your fancy antique shop and plush restaurant.
And we're supposed to sit quietly while these creeps drive us out of business.
Look, we were in business long before you ever heard of the Strip and the taxes we paid. Then you and the others come along and open up these filthy little dives for these young morons, and our business is shot to hell.
Where are these young morons supposed to go to have a little fun if not to filthy little dives like mine? What are they supposed to do? Sit home and watch television while their parents are out making the town?
Well, they don't have to ruin the Strip.
You well, just don't know what you're talking about.
Who doesn't know what they're talking about?
You don't.
Did I lose our heads?
All right, let's not lose our heads. I'm sure Mr. Ross and Mr. Arno aren't proposing that we start pushing these kids around. Of course, we could use tear gas, beat them up, use hand grenades or riot guns. You gentlemen do have your rights, and I'm sure you have been hurt by what's happening. But we've got to remember that these are kids, not anarchists or armed mobs. Our sons and daughters, maybe they are a little mixed up, but so are we at their age. We came out of it all right.
So will these kids. But what do we do in the meantime?
Well, I've got an idea, Perry. You send some of these kids to me. I'd like to talk to them.
Talk to them? Who understands their language?
How about it, Perry?
I'll be glad to.
Good. Maybe when we find out what these kids want, explain our problems and you gentlemen's problems.
You really believe you can talk sense with those kooks? If they had any sense, you think they'd act like that, dress like that, live like that, wear their hair like that?
I don't honestly know. All we can do is try.
The kids and I will cooperate. I promise you that.
If you'll excuse me.
Well, I told you there was no use coming here. He's living in a dream world. Well, we have to get signatures on petitions, buttonhole everybody we know, do something.
You know, I just wonder how many of those kids out there on the Strip really know what a good friend they've got in Walt.
So basically what you're asking for is a change in the curfew law from 10 p.m. to midnight, right?
Just on weekends. Friday and Saturdays. During the week, 10 p.m. is all right. For 6 months.
6 months?
To give us a chance to prove that we are responsible.
And that's what these demonstrations are all about?
There are other things. Kids should be allowed to go to their cars unmolested at curfew.
Let them talk, Perry. That's why they're here. Go on, I'm listening.
Like he said, we want the police to change their attitude. They don't have to act like private servants for the Sunset Strip establishment. And when we're questioned by police, we want to be treated like anyone else. We're enforcement based on law violation, not length of hair, manner, dress, or economic conditions.
You go to college?
I'm in my third year, straight A's.
I see. Anything else?
No, that's about it, basically.
Well, the points concerning my men, I can do something about. Providing the kids stay in line, stay out of trouble.
We're working on that, our own police force.
With armbands, to keep order.
To assist the police, sir.
Well, just so you don't take the law into your own hands. Because of the curfew, that's not in my department, it's a local ordinance.
Which is hurting my business.
That's not the problem here, Perry. I'll see what I can do to follow through. In the meantime, keep a lid on the kids. I think we can straighten this thing out.
We can keep a lid on the kids, but can you hold your police in line?
I'll do my best. That's all I can promise.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Keep an eye on him, Perry.
Try.
That's you, Andy. I want to talk to you.
Okay. Oh, Mom, you promised me you wouldn't. Not tonight. Tonight was supposed to be some kind of a test.
I know, hon. I tried. I really did. But you know all I've gone through. It's too much for anybody. And if you were any kind of a daughter, you'd try and have a little sympathy. Try and help.
Forget it.
The beleaguered Sunset Strip area girded itself in anticipation of another troubled weekend. Police and sheriff's deputies all over the city and county were put on standby alert. It was made public today that merchants' groups and realty associations were demanding a crackdown, stern measures, but enforcement authorities were still asking for calm conciliation. For instance, Walt Lorimer, head of the Hollywood Division of Police, interviewed a few days ago, told me,
"Well, I wouldn't say it was crucial. Serious, maybe. I agree we have a problem, but I think we're well able to keep it under control. But these are kids, our sons, our daughters. Maybe they do create a nuisance ganging up in one small..."
Daughters. Lizanne? Andy? Are you still making the strip scene? What time could you pick me up? Okay. I'll change too.
Yeah. Hey, kid.
There's your blood money. Come on, people.
Hey! There's Herbie. We're 11.
Now we'll see where the action is.
Who's Herbie? The movie star's son with plenty of bread. And no one at home to crack down. Your mother? Lots of them. His old man's been married 6 times.
And so I told this guy, I said, look.
Hi, Herbie.
Hi. Oh, Herb, this chick here is Andy.
It's nice meeting you, Herb.
Nice meeting you. Oh, Bertie, fly away.
Come on, let's groove.
Won't you sit down?
Listen, I'm so excited. I was about to tell you.
Hiya, Grady.
Hey, when did they let you out?
Wait till I tell you. Come.
Well, I tried everything to get along with you. I'm gonna tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm set all night, gonna leave you alone. Don't believe I love you. Everything for you. You left me standing here without you. I'm sick of all your nagging. Gonna leave on your own. Well, I tried.
Hey, you jerk!
Hey!
Call it, man. Not in here.
That's not happening in here, man.
Well, I'm not out in here. Either cool or get out.
Take two, all right?
Charge it.
Hey, man. This place is a drag. They got their own Gestapo.
Well, they're trying to stop the cops from busting the joint. What do I know?
Well, I could care less.
What's the scene?
Coolette, listen to Herbie.
Hey, Donnie's got a place set for a freak out. Let's make it.
A freak out? What about the acid?
Don't worry about that, man. I come ready to fly.
Groovy, I'll get my wheels.
Don't need them. It's a drag.
Well, then let's fly.
Come on, beautiful.
Freak out.
What are you waiting for? I don't know. There's something about your friend Herbie. You ever freaked out? It's a ball. You mean you've never been on a trip? No. Come on, Alice in Wonderland. You haven't lived.
Let's make it.
No, no, thank you. I'll call later.
How's it going out there?
Strangely enough, quiet. Here, take a look. A brawl started a while ago at Pandora's. Like the promise, the kids stopped it.
Well, at least they kept their word. I only wish I could keep mine.
What good was it for me to write to City Hall, the big shots, the county, all the politicians I know?
I can't even get them on this.
I don't understand. Don't they care? Don't they give?
Who knows? Who knows? It's a pressure from guys like Ainsley and Arnold and others, probably. Frank, there's only one answer. They not only don't want those kids making trouble on the strip, they just don't want them there, period.
They'd rather have it bust wide open. Give them an excuse to clear them out of there for good. Well, that's pretty cold-blooded.
Can you think of a better answer? I can't. I've been sitting there nearly going crazy trying.
Well, at least we have a quiet night for a change.
Yeah, quiet. Very.
Have some coffee.
Thanks.
Company. Come on in.
Yes, come right in. Don't mind if I drink.
Oh, wonderful, man. Beautiful. Now, this is really a wild setup.
Right.
Come on. Woo-hoo.
Bring over here. Come on.
Hey, put some cells in the hi-fi, will you?
And make it something way out.
Hey, listen, give me some more ice, will you? I'm telling you, what a party.
Don't worry about a thing. You're going to have a ball.
This is real boss, man.
I got some joints just in case.
Listen, that's your bag, baby, but tonight we have the Milky Way.
Aren't you warm?
Yes, I am.
Hey, Donnie, take this and fly it away.
Sure.
Well, you're next, Scooty.
Sugar? No, thank you.
Lizanne. She's got to be putting me on.
She really isn't, Herbie. She's never been tripping before. It's the acid, sweetie. That's how you do it on a cube of sugar. I know. No, thank you.
What is she doing at this clam bake anyway? What do you think we're going to do, play post office?
Don't look at me. I don't know any more than you do.
Thank you. much of a drag, huh? Hmm? He's chalking up his research. A night out with the weirdos.
I don't think you're weird.
Then we blew it again, because we try very hard to be.
Now who's putting who on?
Touché. But just to show you there's no hard feelings, I brought you a drink. Don't let it bug you. It's harmless. It's diet drink. No calories, nothing. Won't even make you fat, so help me.
I was thirsty.
Proceeding to 1862 Diego Drive.
Uh-uh, little chump.
Now, wait a minute.
Who do you think set her up? The soda pop? Grass is fast, but acid's like lightning now.
Oh. Yeah, but...
You're so
better report in.
Yeah. All right, Unit 3-7. Unit 3-7, over.
All right. Thanks, Red. Well, it's happened. They stepped way out of line tonight. Neighbors phoned in some kids broke into a house on Diego Drive. Our unit's there now, waiting for instructions.
This confirmed?
There's a party going on. Should I tell him to bust it?
No, not yet. You and I'd better be there. If those kids are high enough or wild enough, things might happen.
Our boys might rough them up a little.
It's not only that. I just don't want this incident to add fuel to the fire.
I'll get the car.
All right.
Our car. No, this... Walt Larimer's car. Oh, Walt, what's up?
I haven't the slightest idea.
Well, can I tag along?
No, not this trip.
Well, why not?
I'll tell you all about it when I get back.
Sergeant?
Huh. Larimer himself, huh?
Anything happen?
No, Sarge. No one cut in or out.
Remember now, these are kids. I don't want anybody to have an excuse to yell police brutality. So keep your guns in your holsters and no stick work. Anybody gets hurt in there, you'll answer me personally here.
The heat's out front. Kill the lights. Out the back way.
They spotted us. Let's go.
Remember what I said?
Come on!
else.
We're too late. They all got out the back. Boy, this one's sure been turned on.
Yeah. I'll hold her out here. I want to go see what Tweety's got inside.
What's happened? What's the matter with you? One of our guys hurt a kid?
Not one of us.
Well, tell me what the score is.
I don't know how to tell you. I wish I didn't have to.
Well, don't go up there. Don't be ridiculous.
Won't you can't do any good up there, please.
You're here? What happened?
What do you think happened?
Are you all right?
I'm all right. You're funny.
What's the matter with you? Stop it! Stop it! I want to know what happened.
I'll tell you what happened. Five boys have been here with me.
With you?
Being alone. Oh, do you care?
You know that's not true.
It isn't.
You forgetting I'm your father?
No. I'm not forgetting. But you have. For 4 years. Now let's keep it that way.
Walt, the ambulance is here.
They won't get away with it, Frank. Any of them.
So this is her friend, huh? Young lady, I don't know how much you know about cops, but that's our boss's daughter upstairs.
Andy's father. A cop? She never let on.
So I'm warning you, if you know what's good for, you'll cooperate with us in every way. Take her to the car.
Call you back.
Walter?
All this talk I hear. Bunch of kids breaking into a house. An acid party. Some girl being raped.
Stokes, why don't you just disappear? Vanish.
Look, what's eating you? I'm trying to do my job the same as you do yours. Only the public's got a right to know.
Let me know as soon as my wife calls.
All right, Sergeant.
Everything quiet?
Just like Beverly Hills.
Hey, you want to stay here tonight?
Sure.
Herbert Harley, Donald Itzen. I got a warrant here for your arrest, requested by the Los Angeles Police Department.
What's the charge?
Breaking and entering. Misuse of private property. Creating a disturbance. Rape.
Rape? Oh, is that what she said? Listen, that little trick was asking for it. She was begging.
The only trouble is, Sonny, she wasn't old enough to ask or beg. You ever hear of jailbait? Well, you're gonna find out what it means.
One question, sir. Who is the rat fink that put the finger on us?
Does it make any difference where you're going? Now, I'm required by law to advise you of your rights. You don't have to make any statement. Anything you say now may later be used as evidence against you. You're entitled to legal representation. If you can't afford to pay, a lawyer will be provided at public expense.
Crazy.
Oh, wow.
All right, George, let's go.
Will you please, please stop driving yourself crazy?
What else could I expect?
Her mother's more to blame than you are. There's nothing you could have done. Will you get that through your head? Where are you going?
Where father belongs.
Then get your chin up off the floor, for Andy's sake. Will you?
Yeah, I got it. I'll get right back to you. Oh, sir. Three rape suspects are at the hospital for the girl to identify. But the doctor says she shouldn't be disturbed yet. So the men want to know, do they keep them at the hospital or book them?
Bring them in and book them. What's the big rush anyway?
Walt?
General Hospital, code 3.
Yes, I'll tell Dr. Haynes. Thank you. Working the late shift again, Mr. Lorimer?
No, I have a daughter here. Probably using her mother's maiden name. Dahlia? Andrea Dahlia?
Yes, I'll call.
Man, what a hang-up.
Can you imagine him pinching us for something like this?
It's crazy.
Yeah.
What makes this chick any different than the rest of them?
You lousy, filthy scum, you punks, you... All those punks acting like nothing happened after what they did to my daughter. I couldn't help myself. No father could.
I heard that, Lorimer. I'm gonna have to quote you.
Don't you have any feelings? Don't you know what they did to my daughter? They raped her. She's not even 18 and they fed her drugs and they raped her. The whole bunch of them!
to report this, I suppose.
It's news. And even if I didn't, you think those kids aren't going to spill their guts? You just know they will. Tell Walt, I'm sorry.
What have I done? Suppose I've been carrying my gun.
Sir, you can see your daughter now.
Thank you.
In there, room 133.
So what are you waiting for? We have to see her, you know.
After what I've just done?
Well, don't think about that. Think about Andy. She needs help.
A lot of help I can give her.
What happened to me isn't usually fatal.
I guess you heard what just happened.
Who could help but hear it? The whole hospital heard. It's par for the course.
I don't think I deserve that, not from you anyway.
I'm sorry, but I don't have any medals.
Look, Andy, what I did because I thought... Well, I was wrong.
You thought. Were your thoughts ever where they should have been?
Wait a minute. Maybe I'm a little thick, but what is this?
What difference does it make?
I want to know.
Sure. Now? Where were you before? How come this sudden concern over me? Beating up some kids because I said they took advantage of me.
Knowing what happened to you, I lost control of myself.
Would it have made any difference if it had been another girl? What were you doing? Playing hero? Or just feeling guilty because you haven't even bothered to see me all these years?
When your mother moved away, she never told me where.
Oh, come on. You of all people could have found out. Care. Busy making speeches on television.
Andy, I do.
I say, Walt. Hi, Andy. Say, Walt, I'm sorry to interrupt, but all hell's about to break loose out in the strip.
Huh?
Well, radio and TV are full of what happened here. That started it. You better get out there. We're going to have our hands full.
What can I...
What are you going to do? Turn in your badge? Resign?
Resign?
Well, sure. Isn't that the easy way? Haven't you always run away from responsibility?
Look, Andy, I know. I understand how you feel, but you're wrong. As God is my judge, you're wrong.
I'm wrong.
Honey, I'd really like to talk about this. Can I come back later? Right now, there's not enough time.
That's just it. There never was enough time. Not now, not later, not any time. Just forget it.
We have just returned from General Hospital. And the news of Walt Lorimer's assault on three of the rape suspects has spread like wildfire on the strip. Juveniles on their way home are reported thronging back to the West Hollywood area.
Crowds in the youth night spots are chanting defiance of curfew regulations and refusing to move aside on police instructions. Special police and sheriff deputies in record numbers are being mobilized and dispatched to the beleaguered Sunset Strip area. The irony is that Walter Lorimer was known all over the city as the enemy of violence and the best friend of the boys and girls.
If I were Mr. Lorimer, the last place I'd be seen tonight is on Sunset Strip.
Today in Washington.
How'd it go with Andy?
Could have been worse. I better get out on the strip and try to hold it down. After the way I lectured, no brutality, no violence. Then they see something happen to me personally and they know how much I really believe in what I preach. Thanks very much, Helen, for... Come on, Frank.
See you.
This should answer that cop. Let's see. Maxine, that's telling him. Well, this will show him, too.
That's not bad. What'll you say this one? We want peace, not police.
Hey, that rhymes.
It's a real groove, ain't it?
Yeah.
You gotta make a career out of that.
You mean I ought to become a poet?
No, a house painter.
Forget her, pal. She don't dig realism.
Where'd you learn to print like that anyway?
Why?
There'll be TV cameras all over the strip.
Hey, let's not hassle among ourselves. Say that for the police.
Well, chum, tonight is really the night.
Kind of a shame.
Yeah, it's the best thing that could have happened. How else could we get rid of those kooks once and for all? After what those punks did to that girl, they've lost all public sympathy. Now the cops and the deputies won't have to hold anything back.
Well, I just hope nobody gets hurt.
Well, they're bound to lay the wood to a few heads, but isn't it worth it? Hmm?
This just right. Good work. Frank.
Break it up. Everybody 18 and under, home. Let's go either in or out. Come on, let's go. Break it up. Let's go. Move along. Come on, we got to clear this area. Come on, let's go. Break it up. Let's go. Either in or out. Come on, move along. Let's go. Come on, break it up. Good evening, sir.
How are you, Sergeant? How's it going? Well, if that's all it is, it's all right, Sergeant. Just keep it that way.
Yeah,
both of you sit there and wait.
Laura, you lousy cop!
Don't you touch that kid! Just put him in the wagon.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I saw what you did on the strip, on television.
They discharged you from the hospital, did they?
They wanted to take me home.
You're all right, aren't you?
Yeah, didn't you hear what I said? They wanted to take me home.
Yes, I heard you.
I didn't want to go.
I'm glad.
Yeah, the things I said at the hospital.
How's your mother? I mean,
I know. Pretty bad.
My car's out front. Come on, I'll take you home with me.
Don't you have any work to do?
Oh, the strip's under control. The kids are all gone.
Where will they go now?
I only wish I knew.
That is the question. You can close down their clubs, impose curfews, arrest them, punish their neglectful parents. But one fact remains. Soon, half the world's population will be under 25 years of age. They must go somewhere. Where will they go? What will they do?